السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعين به ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، جزاكم الله خير ودير سيد براذرز وسيسترز. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless this gathering and make this gathering for his sake. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make this gathering beneficial with Allah ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, one of the things that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us, he taught us that النِّسَاءُ شَقَائِقُ الرِّجَالِ, that women are the halves, women are the partners of men, and the importance of women in society. Unfortunately, we live in a time where people sometimes, or many times, they tend to undermine the role of women. Because the issue here, brothers and sisters, is that sometimes people want to put women in positions that is going to be, that is going to harm the overall status and the important status of the women. Brothers and sisters, before Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described to us the situation of women. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَإِذَا بُشِّرَ أَحَدُهُمْ بِالْأُنْثَى ضَلَّ وَجُهُ مُسْوَدًّا وَهُوَ كَظِيمٌ. And if someone told them, if one told those Arabs in the back in the days of ignorance that they are about to have a female, his face would turn black, you know. But Islam came and had given the rights to the women to vote, a right woman with dignity, a right woman to have an important life, an important duties in whether her life is beside her husband or at home or in other places. Brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, yeah, or Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told us, he said, من عالى جارتين حتى تبلغا جاء يوم القيامة, you know, وأنا وهو كهاتين. Whoever took care of two girls, or he abroad two girls, and he took care of them, this man is going to come in the hereafter, me and he is closer to me like this. He did not say this about boys. He did not say this about anything else. He said, whoever took care of two girls and he abroad them in the best of way, he's going to come and be close to me in the hereafter just like this. Brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَهُنَّ مِثْلُ الَّذِي عَلَيْهِنَّ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ, that they should deserve whatever a man would expect out of them. So they have the equal rights, you know, in many situations when it comes to men. And that's the brother and sisters, that's the part that many of us need to understand. That when we say equal, that does not mean equal in everything. Yeah, there's a lot of things that in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have made equal. Like for instance, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَالْمُؤْمِنُونَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتُ بَعْضُهُمْ أَوْلِيَاءُ بَعْضٍ, believing women and believing men, you know, إن المسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات والقانتين والقانتات. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said the believing women and the believing men, the righteous women and righteous men. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala equal. But think of sometimes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have given things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to women, he have not given it to men. And sometimes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have given things to men, have not given to women. So each of they're different in their natures and they're different in their responsibilities because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created them different. You know, so Allah subhanahu so yeah, for instance, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have honored يعني, the women and he have given a whole lengthy surah by the name of women, and Nisa, Surah An-Nisa, the chapter of women. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala he Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he outlawed a man to hit a woman, you know. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said it's haram for a man to hit a woman in her face. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said وَوَصَيْنَا الْإِنسَانَ يعني بِوَالِدَيْهِ حَمَلَتْهُ أُمُّهُ وَهْنًا عَلَى وَهْنًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have given a very high status to a woman, يعني, in comparison to a man. Like for instance, when a man came to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he told him, and he asked him, who is more honorable, to me. He said, your mom, then your mom, then your mom, and then the last, the fourth person was his father. So who are they equal in the situation? No, the woman, the mother is much, much more important when it comes to his religion. يعني, a man would not even smell Jannah if his mother is not happy with him. You see? So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يعني, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also honored the sister and her status, subhanAllah. So brothers and sisters, يعني, honoring a woman is very important. But when we say honoring them is putting them in the right, but just like men have the right spot in within the family, within society, and etc. So, يعني, and that's why the role of woman, brother and sister, is very important and very critical if we put it in the right position. You know, one time a group of women came to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they said the following: غلبنا عليك الرجال. It's like men, they're complaining. Men have overtaken everything, all your time. You know, فجعل لنا يوما من نفسك. Give us a day that we could sit with you. So Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said he promised them to sit with them, and he was alternating between them and the men, and also he gave them this special يعني special promise. He said, ما من كنا امرأة تقدم ثلاثة من ولدها أو اثنين إلا كان لها حجابا من النار يوم القيامة. He said, there is no woman, or that يعني, for instance, she lost two kids or lost three kids, you know, while she is living, unless Allah subhanahu and she became patient, unless Allah, they will become her children hereafter. That's a special for women. Also, it was encouraged for women to learn and seek education and become knowledgeable. يعني Aisha radiallahu anha, where he said, نعم النساء الأنصار. The best of women, the women of Ansar, the women of Medina. Why? لم يمنعهن الحياء أن يتفقهن في الدين. It was the حياء, or being shy, did not prevent them from learning more about the deen. So here, حياء, again, brothers and sisters, حياء, it's important for a woman to have a حياء, and it's important for a man to have a حياء too. But the حياء of women is more prevalent and more common in women. So, but even يعني حياء, when it comes to حياء, to prevent you from learning, no, we're encouraged to learn and seek education, as long as all the rules and regulations are being respected, you know, but it's more important for them to seek education within the deen more than anything else, not the last thing. So it's important, brothers and sisters, that يعني, because thing is, a woman, when she's a mother, who's going to teach the children the deen? When you are a mother, who's going to teach the children their salah and their zakah and the basics of their deen? Because the father is, a lot of time he's out running after to provide for the family. But who's going to teach the children the right from the wrong? The mom. And if, how the mom is going to upbring her children in the right way if she does not know? You know, and that's why one of the most important building blocks in the family is the woman, and that's why once you destroy the responsibility of a woman in a family structure, society is gone. When you have, for instance, women who throw their children in daycares or to throw their children in places where there is no children, they don't feel the existence of their mother. These a lot of these children is going to feel the attached. A lot of these children sometimes will feel depressed. A lot of these children feel that someone else, they're loyal for someone else other than their mom, especially in the younger years. So, brothers and sisters, it's important for us to know that there has to be some sort of a child. He sees his mother in the household more than anything else, you know. And that's why it's important, brother and sister, for us to realize the importance and the depth of the role of women in society, you know. Yeah, and one time, يعني الصحابة were saying this. ما شكل علينا أصحاب الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم حديث قط فسألنا عائشة. He said like every time they used to dispute among themselves about an issue and they don't know who should ask, who do they go back to? They go back to asking عائشة رضي الله عنها because she was so knowledgeable. ما شاء الله. يعني she is one of the second most important narrator of hadith. سبحان الله. إلا وجدنا عندها منه علما. يعني and if we go back there we always يعني we get the things that we want. سبحان الله. And that's the kind of knowledge, the knowledge of the deen, the knowledge of how to live our life, the knowledge of how to behave and respect and honor and know the way of life. And that's why when you have, for instance, women and men not given that responsibility of their roles toward their children, the roles toward each other, that's how you destroy society, you know. In another hadith, عن ربيع بنت معوث رضي الله عنها قالت كنا نغزو مع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فنسقي القوم ونخدمهم ونرد الجرحى والقتل إلى المدينة. يعني لقد حتى even in the times of war, look how the women used to help out. He said we used to go out with Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم and so whoever thirsty we used to give them water ونخدمهم and we used to serve them ونرد الجرحى and we used to cure and take care of the wound, the people who are wounded and the people who and help those who have died and return them to the Medina. Subhanallah. And the men used to be in the front of the field, okay, and the women used to be in the back trying to help out with whatever that they can. But there is an important role in this situation, brothers and sisters, you know. And another hadith, and this is by Umm Atiyah al-Ansariyah. She said, غزوت مع الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم سبع غزوات. I have went with Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم seven times, يعني into war. أخلفهم في رحالهم, and I used to be with them. فأصنع لهم الطعام, I used to prepare for them food. وأداوي الجرحى, and I used to heal the people who are wounded. وأقوم على المرضى, and be on top of the people who are sick. فسبحان الله. So all of this, brothers and sisters, shows the essence and the importance of the role of women in society. Again, يعني, and unfortunately, you have people nowadays in two extremes. You know, they want people to have the ultra neo feminism who try to tell you men and women are equal in every single thing, and you have people, and the people who call themselves extreme Muslims, what they say, they absolutely, ignore the role of women, and they say she's not allowed to seek education, and they treat her like a cattle, al-iyadu billah, like she's subhuman, and this is wrong. يعني Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, يعني he utilized women in the one of the most important aspects of his life. You know, Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he migrated from Mecca to Medina, okay, who he went after whom? Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu, to go out with him, right? So he came to Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu, he told him, you know, I was told to migrate. So Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu, he said, oh, Prophet of Allah, take my cattle. Yeah, you take my cattle and I'll take mine. He said, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, I'll take it, but I'll pay for it. So, yeah, that shows you the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, even though he had the dignity of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that even though he was offered something, he said, yes, I'll take it. Okay, you have an extra one? No, he said, I'll take it, but I'll pay for it. But what happened is, you know, they needed a plan to how, who's going to help them, who's going to profit, give them, bring them food in the way. And that's why Asma radiallahu anhu, Asma bint Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu, they call her dhunnataqain, the woman with two sheets of cloth. Why? Because she used to have a sheet of cloth that she used to tie around her waist when she used to work. And she took that sheet and she ripped it, and she took one to wrap around the water and another one to wrap around the food, and she used to carry them to Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and her father. So she used to struggle. She used to struggle to, and she served Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in this important time. How? Because, يعني subhanAllah, because of يعني the importance of her duties, brothers and sisters. So that shows you, يعني even in the times of extreme need, when Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was in need of sadaqat, he used to reach out to the women and tell them, donate. تصدقوا تصدقوا هنيسا. He said, وكانوا أكثر من يصدق النساء. And the most of the people who used to donate were women. They used to help out for people who are needy. The people, they used to help out when there is time of hardship. So how did that come about? Because of the importance of women, brothers and sisters. Because of women, and their role, the ummah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam have brought one of the most important men that ever have witnessed. Yeah, subhanallah. When we talk about Imam Ibn Taymiyyah, who is Taymiyyah? Yeah, one of the greatest scholars of Islam, Imam Ibn Taymiyyah. Who is Taymiyyah? His mother. He is the son of his mother, and his father was not mentioned, and that's why, يعني, it's important for them for them in the field of knowledge, and even Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he talks about the wives of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam of how they should spread the knowledge of this deen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَاذْكُرْنَ مَا يُتْلَى فِي بُيُوتِكِنَّ مِنَ الْآيَاتِ مِنَ آيَاتِ اللَّهِ وَالْحِكْمَةِ. And mention, O wives of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what do you know about the verses that you have heard and about the hikmah, يعني the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Shows you what? Showed you that, يعني, how they're important. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have given glad tiding of one of the most important women that ever lived, the wife of Sayyidina Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Khadija radiallahu anha, who was the comforter of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the beginning of his message, who was stood with him all the way through his the most critical aspect of his life, and possibly if it wasn't Salaam alaikum. I'm sorry, the connection was got disconnected. So as we were saying, Imam Ibn Taymiyyah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, why he was, yani, came to this important, yani, why he became so important, if it wasn't for his mother, because we call him Imam Ibn Taymiyyah. Taymiyyah is his mother. When we look at, for instance, Imam Sufyan al-Thawri, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with him, you know, look at this. His mother used to tell him, Ya bunay in kunta in kitabta 10 ahruf, fanzur hal tara fi nafsiki min ziyadati min khashyatika wa hilmiki. Yeah, she used to teach him. Oh, my son, every time you write out, يعني, 10 letters as you are seeking knowledge, do you feel that your faith have increased, or do you feel that you are more fearful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Subhanallah. That's what the mother used to teach. Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, who was Imam Ahmad for his mother, you know, Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, he used to say, فحفظتني أمي القرآن وعمري 10 سنوات. Like, my mother, she made me memorize the Quran. She taught me to memorize the Quran when I was 10 years. Allahu Akbar. فسبحانallah, يعني, and many like them, Imam al-Shafi'i, يعني, who يعني, the whole madhab was after him. If it, who was he for the, wasn't for the upbringing of his mother? Imam, يعني, Imam Anas ibn Malik. يعني, we were taught, when we talk about Imam ibn Malik, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala please him, he said, كانت أمي تلبسني الثياب وتعممني. My mom used to take care of me, and she used to, you know, make me wear the turban. She used to teach me how to wear the turban before I go to learn from the scholars. But subhanAllah, all these things, brothers and sisters, shows you the vital aspect of the importance of the role of women. So, but unfortunately, now we live in a time where people abuse it in the both extremes that I mentioned. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide all of us, and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to show us the right path. Jazakumullah khair, wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.